I'm Jennifer Carmarker. I'm the editor of the Laguna Woods Globe, and with me today is Kitty Platt and Sue Margolis, and they are from the Garden Centers Club. Now, with spring on its way, there's a lot of interest, of course, in gardens. And although I'm not a gardener, I mean, I actually killed my poinsettia before Christmas, I know that there are a lot of avid gardeners here in the village. And one question I do have is, what is the difference between the Garden Centers Club and the Garden Club?
The Garden Centers Club is primarily people who have plots in the garden centers. So there right now are two garden centers, Garden Center 1 and Garden Center 2, and they're available for lease to the residents here, although there's a shortage of plots right now and a waiting list. So the main difference is we do, in the Garden Centers Club, we do vegetable, fruit tree, and flower gardening. In the Garden Club, it's primarily people who garden at home on their porches and do things like flower arrangements and artistic things with flowers.
Great. So tell me about some of the activities that your club gets involved in.
Our club has speakers. We have meetings, about 6 or 7 meetings a year, and we invite speakers to present on different gardening topics. A lot of times their speakers are experts in the field. They're Orange County master gardeners or local nursery, people from local nurseries, people from local composting place, soil experts, that type of thing. Any topic that would improve a garden plot.
Okay, and do you have to have a garden plot to be a member of the club or to go to club meetings?
No, you don't. There are a lot of people that are on the garden plot waiting list, waiting to receive garden plots when they're available. And so you can come and listen to the topics, because people who are waiting for a plot are generally interested in the same topics that the speakers are talking about.
Okay, and I understand that there's two beautiful garden centers here in our community, but there is a shortage of plots. What can you tell me about that?
Okay, the original plan for over 10 years, there was a plan to build a Garden Center 3 to add on more Garden Center plots. But over that time, as the plans progressed, different things got put on hold and changed around a lot. So there were originally more plots than there are now in Garden Center 1, but Moulton Parkway was widened, and that took away a lot of the plots that originally belonged in Garden Center 1. So previously there were more garden plots available than there are now. And even before that the gardens were taken away, for more than 10 years, people had been planning on expanding to a Garden Center 3, that type of concept. So lots of plans were made, and when Moulton was widened, the Laguna Woods Village received money for taking the land that was lost there, that was supposedly going to be appropriated to replacing those plots with new plots. But that has not happened, although we were expecting it to happen. The plan was to put Garden Centers 3 on land that was not really zoned for it. And so we had always been reassured that when the land was zoned, the plans were still in place, and that was going to happen. And so people that wanted a garden plot could actually receive one.
Tell me, how many, are there people on a waiting list then for plots?
Yes, there are. So originally, even when there was plots that were available than are now, there was a waiting list of about 400. So they went through the waiting list to make sure all those people were waiting and how many plots were available. And GRF, that's one of the things they're doing, is cleaning up there, keeping track of the plots and the people waiting. And the latest that we have is there are almost 300 people still on the waiting list. Actually, 294 residents waiting for a garden plot right now. And the next person that's in line to receive the next available garden plot, when that happens, will have been on the waiting list for over 4 years.
Well, Sue, can you tell me, is GRF doing anything to make more plots available?
Well, they've done a number of things. They've really made changes at the Garden Center, it was an unmaintained amenity, essentially. And so this year they planted trees along Moulton to block the view for what they called the shanty town. They didn't like the looks of it. They removed the shade house from Garden Center 1 to make plots there. It was underutilized, and so there are going to be some new plots there. Then they've put in new fencing structures that they want us to comply with, and they built models of those over at Garden Center 3. The cost is about $1,200 for fencing materials. That isn't even incorporating the to build price. And there was no record kept on how long it took to build, but we observed there were three people over a number of 6 weeks or so. The future plans are that we've been begging for is a security fence, because there is a lot now with the visibility of these gardens. There are a lot of people off the street walking through, and low-hanging fruit is low-hanging fruit. So they're planning to put in the controlled access at both garden centers. But there is no electricity at Garden Center 1, so it's just going to be a key code, and you know that'll be out before the week's out. At Garden Center 2, it'll require a swiping of your key. To increase the number of tree plots, they're going to increase the number of plots. They're taking tree plots and making them into garden plots. They're taking some of the larger plots and dividing them up where people have invested a lot of money and taking plots away from them, so that's not really what they want. There are all kinds of new regulations, and people are very fearful that their fence isn't going to meet the requirements, and spending a couple of $1,000s on a fence. So a number of people will be giving up their plots at that time.
And then those will go to the people on the list.
Well, when people on the list find out that it's going to cost them $2,000 to put a fence in, they're sort of discouraging gardening, which is not what we really want to do.
Mm-hmm. So is your club working with Golden Rain Foundation to come up with some solutions?
Well, we are sort of on the periphery. We haven't really, that is one of the things that we want to do this next year, and we want people to sign up in four gardens so that we know how many are needed, and then we can lobby them in order to get more Garden Center 3 on its way. And we're really, that's our goal for this year, is to get it started.
Okay, well, let's hope for good things for Garden Center, and that everyone who wants a plot can get one. Thank you, ladies.
Thank you.
I'm Jennifer Carmarker, and please make sure to pick up a globe on Thursday.